He walks on. He goes upstairs. Some of the subordinates look at him and they just sort of, they back off. Now, what is this man going through? He has entered office thinking that he's a perfectly healthy individual who's going back to work. Everybody around him sort of passes nasty remarks, shuns him. And somewhere along the day, somebody just happens to tell him that, are you HIV positive or something to that effect. Here is a man who is absolutely competent. He knows his job. He knows how to do his job. But suddenly, nobody wants him. What's happened? Overnight. He's HIV positive. That's what's happened. And we don't know how to deal with it. That's what's happened. So he has to suffer the consequences. This man eventually committed suicide. Unable to bear the humiliation of being told that he's HIV positive and incapable of being a productive member of society, he just lost hope. This is not something that happened to just one such person. People who work with HIV, people who are HIV, tell us that in 90% of the cases, when a person is told that he's HIV positive, one of the first few thoughts that cross his mind is of suicide. Why? You don't think of suicide when you're told you have cancer. You don't think of suicide when you're told you have tuberculosis. They're just as fatal a disease. Then why does that person think of suicide when he's told he has HIV? He's HIV positive. Firstly, because we have spread this thing about HIV that HIV equal to death, HIV equal to discrimination, HIV equal to you have no right to live.